Today, we're going to do an unboxing and review of the brand new Nvidia Titan RTX. I will explain why the 24GB frame buffer is a game changer for memory-bound applications like Adobe Premiere and Mistika VR. I will compare the Titan RTX with my other graphic cards, the Nvidia RTX 2080 Ti right here. If you have your eyes on the Titan RTX and looking for an upgrade in 8K stereoscopic VR video post-production, this is the video for you. Let's dive right in. The reason for my upgrade, if you follow my Instagram or Facebook post, is I hit some kind of bottleneck on my 8K editing pipeline. I can't deliver cut on time to the clients, which lead to angry producer and angry clients. 8K editing in Adobe Premiere, After Effects, or Blender eats up a lot of memory because it's all CUDA accelerated playback, and it all happens to fall on the GPU. So there are times when lots of immersive video filters or effects on my timeline, I will hit maximize memory allowance on the RTX card, which is 11GB. To make things worse, with third-party overclocking RTX, will crash your system when you run out of frame buffer, which is the last thing you want. Titan RTX is not for everyone though. If you are a VR gamer using the latest Oculus Rift S, you are not gonna benefit much from the Titan RTX. You better off stick to my other recommendation, which is right here, the RTX 2080 Ti, or even the 2080. And if you are a serious VR gamer, well, you might also skip the Oculus Quest, because the Oculus Rift S will be a better upgrade for you to leverage the power of your gaming PC. Also, Titan RTX will not magically increase the playback and rendering speed of your current system unless you have the PC to match its power. To bring Titan RTX to its full potential, I ask Main Gear to build me the PC dedicated to 8K VR editing and post-production using Adobe Premiere and After Effects. It is not a gamer PC, but a powerful workstation that can take on even 11K in Star 260 Titan footage. Haha, Titan match Titan. No pun intended. I'm not going to go into the detailed spec of my main gear PC. This will be another video because it's complicated. But just to know, my CPU of choice is the Intel i9-9980EX. An 18-core CPU with turbo boost to 4.40 GHz. So why not AMD Threadripper's 2990WX with the 32 cores? Well, there are many reasons why I choose Intel instead of AMD Threadripper's, but the most obvious one is the Thunderbolt 3 support, which I mentioned in my video here. Basically, my bottleneck on 8K 3D 360 production will be in the storage most of the time. And having a Thunderbolt-based RAID 0 drive like the G-Drive Shuttle XL or the Lazy 6-Pack is essential. Okay, let's take a look at my current Nvidia RTX 2080 Ti performance inside Adobe Premiere. Here is an 8K stereoscopic top and bottom project I did shot with the Insta360 Pro 2. Even have a real-time playback no matter what GPU I used. So I will highly recommend you stick to my proxy workflow right here. Premiere is kind of leveraging GPU acceleration with CUDA for Nvidia graphic cards, but Premiere is not 100% utilizing GPU render. So for regular 4K 2D video editing or rendering, you won't benefit too much from the Titan RTX. But for immersive video editing, all the effects or video filters you see here are GPU accelerated. To easily see that, you can turn off hardware acceleration and immediately you see this red warning bar. So To truly benefit from your fancy GPU right here, you need to make sure your video filters are all GPU accelerated. All native immersive video filters, Boris Effect Continuum VR units, Mocha VR, Metal Mantra, Revision Effects, and Neat Video Denoiser you see right here are all GPU accelerated. Each decision you make on how to process your video footage will significantly impact your time span on playback and render. And that is why it's so important to make smart choices. Not all VR video need sharpening if that means saving you hours of rendering time. So my render of this 10-second 8K 3D video with all the immersive filters and ambisonic audio take around 17 minutes to finish. Looking at the resource monitor, both my CPU and GPU are not maxed out, but the dedicated GPU memory is hitting 7.5 to 8 gigabytes. That is just a 10 second test, but for this video, which is 17 minutes long, way too long for VR by the way, the GPU memory will eventually hit 11 gigabyte ceiling. You also see the GPU stack here with the task manager and the GPU Z for reference. So now I switch to Titan RTX with the exact same PC from main gear. Before I hit render, I open up Neat Video version 5 and take a look at the performance tab. When I use only GPU render, I got average 1.03 frame per second, which is faster than the CPU with 0.8 frame per second. I have a fast CPU by the way. I can relocate more GPU memory to this render to increase the speed, which I cannot on the RTX 2080 Ti 11GB memory. The total render time of the exact same 10 second clip took about 13 minutes to finish, which is 4 minutes increased speed. It does not look significant, but think about it, it adds up. The longer the clips and more GPU accelerated video filters you use, the more time you will save. That is more time you can be productive instead of waiting around or screaming at your PC. Look at the monitor here. The CPU is less taxing compared to the RTX 2080 Ti, and we use 21.5 gigabyte memory on this render, which is significantly higher. You also notice GPU resources is around 70% to compared to the 2080 Ti, which is around 50%. Is that mean Premiere is more optimized to Titan RTX? We don't know. We are using the studio drive from Nvidia, so maybe the Titan RTX is optimized. Number is number. It is faster, and that's all you need to know. I quickly jump over to Mistika VR and do some rendering in ProRes 3D 8K. In average around 3.8 frames per second, which is a pretty good speed compared to what I usually get around 2.6 frames per second. So in conclusion, don't expect a night and day performance increase from upgrading to Titan RTX. But if you can find clients or projects to justify the cost, it is a nice upgrade if you have the CPU and PC to match that. 8K production is becoming more and more common in the immersive filmmaking world. And new VR headsets are coming out that will greatly benefit from this. I will continue to make more content on how to leverage the Nvidia Titan RTX using software like V-Ray's Redshift with Cinema 4D, and how to build your workflow to increase productivity with all this new technology. The next tutorial, I will focusing on Oculus Rift S and the Titan RTX and the Titan 2080 Ti to find out how they perform in demanding VR environment. So, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. Give me a thumb up if you find this video helpful. and comment below on what you want to learn next or what you want your boy Hugh to test for you. And I have you covered. See you next time in VR.